thank you all so much for being here. I want you all to give yourselves a round of applause for being here for the very first sold-out show back from quarantine at maximum capacity. At this time, we please ask you to take a moment, silence your phones. That being said, at the Green Room 42, the use of photography and recording is strictly encouraged. Please tag us in your pictures, your videos at the Green Room 42. If you'd like to order something during the performance, our servers will be available throughout the duration of the show, or you can use the table number on your lamp to order online. With those few necessities out of the way, please put your hands together for the reasons you're all here. Get rowdy, get raucous, for Eva Novara!
Specifically, I will treat you if you get get this right.
Wales.
Scotland.
Ooh, two brain corrects. Extremely wrong.
Yeah,
you're close.
About 300 miles too far.
Yeah, 300 miles to north.
Yes, very good, Eva.
Thank you. Geography. London is the closest so far.
Ireland!
Whoa!
No, it's a B.
But take the Brit.
Britain. Oh, wait, who said that?
Wait, who sort of said Britain?
Brighton! There we go!
Oh, well done! See, your first show back. And we're learning things. It's like school! Hi, everyone. This is awesome. How's everyone doing tonight? I know they said to film, please do. But if a bitch messes up and you post it, that's really rude. It's really disrespectful. No, but seriously, our goal tonight is to have the best time. You can't see underneath my Quaker dress, but but I am shaking because it's so awesome to see this room packed again. It's been 55 years since we performed live, and I don't remember. Yeah, it's been a long time, and I know you are all as eager to drink and eat the hummus and kreidler. Very good, by the way. To hear some live music. So, without further ado, please, my incredible pianist, Jude Owanula. I have one question before I start. May I please have a double gin on the rocks? Tanqueray, please. Because listen, if I'm drinking, hopefully you'll be drinking, and then that means that I will sound better, hopefully. And also, during the show tonight, we will be playing a drinking game. And TikTok has given away all the good skin secrets, and I don't trust any of us. So I will be IDing you, but we will be playing a drinking game tonight, and I have work tomorrow at 10, so I'm the one that's gambling here with my career. So, she's like, you got this. But my name is Eben Wilzada. This show is called So This Is Love. No real relation to what I'm going to sing tonight. It's pretty much all love songs. A bitch loves a ballad. I love to sing about heartbreak. Even though I'm perfectly happy, I just love singing about it. It's a lot of fun. And the one original musical theater bitch that I know whose definition is, is Ebony, right?
Yes.
Everyone's like, yeah. What a sad life. You do all you can to educate yourself with what you've got, and you die. after Marius, too. What a waste of space. Who's played Ebony in here? Anybody?
Woo!
Yeah, wow. So you get that shit. Like, it's even watching it, it's hard to watch. It's hard to be in, you know? Anyway, this is funny. There was a time in Les Mis, when I was doing Ebony in London, where she gets shot and dies. I mean, if I'm giving anything away to you, then why are you in New York City? And I'm supposed to climb over the barrier, and somebody's supposed to say, there's a boy climbing over the barricade, and you're supposed to hear, like, two shots, right? And then she covers up her gunshot, and she's like, oh, shit. There was a night where I guess the person on sound was like this, because instead of, it was like, there's a boy climbing the barricade. Thankfully, they didn't see me until after I went over the barricade, but I was like, now you put me in a bad position. I have to act very hard. So I'm sliding down the barricade. But I thought, how fun would it be to sing on my own? Don't make fun of me. I have to sing this in a British accent because we were literally, any American doing this part, they were like, you need to get every vowel correct. And wow, even more pressure to be on stage with a Brit.
Woo!
Right. And now I'm all alone again, no one to go, no one to turn to. Without a home, without a friend, without a face to say hello to. Tam is supposed to be 3 years old, but they hire 5, 6 years old, like year olds, because they're more mature. I'm joking. I love them so much. But these are you know, these kids, they drink their milk. They're ready to go, and they're pretty heavy. So there was this has nothing to do with it, by the way. Just picturing me holding a child on my hip, and then on the other hip, a bag with a gun in it. It's ready to go. We had one night. It was the end of a really, really good show. It's an epic finale. I walk down, the whole freaking scrim opens, and we walk down with this incredible grand music, and everyone's on the edge of their seats because of all the work we've done. And I'm holding little Tam's hand, and I put him down here, and I'm singing to him, "Now, Tam, my brave boy, our long wait has ended." And you know what this little shit's doing? The fuck? So I think in my head, there's only two solutions here. I can either continue to let him do the pee-pee dance, which
sandwich.
0 out of 5 stars. Or I can make sure that the show continues to go smoothly and all the work we've done is, you know, not for naught. And so I hold him and I'm finishing the thing and he wraps his little legs around me and I'm just crying and I'm like, and then say goodbye. Go ahead. Do it. Go. Just go. Just go. Peed on. And what's even more funny is that Carissa's supposed to come in and hear this gunshot, right? Because, you know, she's tired of that show, too. So I'm trying to be honest with y'all. So he's supposed to come in and see my body go, Kim! And, like, go up to me and hold my body and say, what have you done, Kim? Instead, that night, because there was, like, little pee-pee on over my chest, he hears the gunshot and goes, Kim! Kim! What have you done, Kim? Why? What's hilarious is when the show finished, he could obviously tell like it was pee-pee. And so in his English accent, oh, thank you, legend, thank you so much. In his accent, the curtains come down and the stage was black, and he's like, what the fuck was that? So fucking bad. He's like, was that piss? You pissed yourself. Disgusting. I was like, it was me. And I had to take my underneath my aldine, my costume, I'm wearing silk trousers, sticking to my legs like no one's business. I know, disgusting, but you laugh at it. That's why we're doing a show tonight. You're welcome. So on the topic of love, anyone know about it? Love. Everyone's like, the fuck was that word after this year and a half? We haven't used that word in so long. But you know what? Don't we all love performing and theater and music and art and human connection? That's what it's about, people. Actually, before we continue, salut, cheers. Cheers, that's right, that was a test. I'm trying to make sure I'll pay attention to drinking, if you can. Oh, that's great. So, from living on this earth for 25 years, life's good. Don't worry. I've learned a lot about love in many ways in my life. Romantic, loving my job, loving the passions that I feel are connected to me, make me connected to the earth and to life. But there's one love that is harder to figure out. All of you are like, self-love. Can't you read my mind? It's been a rough year. So before we continue and sweep, before we go on to the next song, I just wanted to say that this next song is dedicated to all of us in here who have, and I'm talking to all of us, don't lie, it's been rough, who need to hear somebody say to their beautiful face that you are very, very, very loved. You are very, very worthy. Please stay here as long as you can, because we love having you. Really dark intro to a very actual great pop song. This is Only Love You Heard Like This. Great.
Wouldn't care if you walked away.
time you're there, I'm going to stay.
Speechless, so speechless. I can't
can't believe how you slurred at me with your half-wide broken jaw, with your tight jeans, with your long hair. Bubble dreams, bubble dreamsy. I can't believe how you looked at me with your Johnny Walker eyes. He's gonna get you, and after he's through, there's gonna be no love left to write. And I know that it's complicated, but I'm a loser in love, so baby, raise a glass to mend all the broken hearts of all my fucked up friends. I'll never talk again. Oh boy, you've left me speechless. You've left me speechless, so speechless. And I'll never love again. Oh boy, you've left me speechless. You've left me speechless, so speechless.
Wise words. No one knows the world. Eartha Kitt. Thank you. Thank you very much. Appreciate it. Love her nails. I can see them here. They look great. Really good. I didn't get mine though, but it doesn't matter. So every time I do a song, a solo show, I always have to sing Amy Winehouse. Thank you. Amy Winehouse is, to me, my favorite artist ever. And about a month ago was the anniversary of her death. 10 years, yeah. Rest in power, absolutely. Growing up, I listened to a lot of very random music. Santana. Yeah, where are you from, sir? You're from California? West Side? Oh, yeah. 619. Oh, who else is 619?
Right here.
Are you kidding me? I have never, and I mean never, done a show here where someone's like, I'm from San Diego. We were just there. Los Angeles? That's too cool for me. It's too cool. Is this what the girls wear at Nobu when they get their pictures taken in Malibu? Like, I can make fun of that all day, baby. I can make fun of that. But I listened to Santana, No Doubt, this really random album called Lord Song. It's three white people from the South who sang, like, and I mean, like, did a whole, they're incredible. I think it was one of those garage sale items that my parents just always put on because it was so good. Lord's Song. A lot of Ella Fitzgerald, a lot of Louis Armstrong. My dad was a jazz major in college. He graduated to be a music teacher. And then he realized, oh fuck, I have a 2-year-old. Sorry. I also listened to a lot of Amy. My dad talked a lot about her, and I was so inspired by her. I remember buying my first vinyl, one of her records, Back to Black, when I was in my Zooey Deschanel, like, fringe and, like, cutesy beach phase. And I played it, and I just sat there and listened to the whole thing, and I was like, what the fuck? That woman had something to say. And the wrong people pushed her in the wrong direction. And it made me think, I'm so grateful to have people in my life who never want me to go in the wrong direction. And I hope that you all have that, starting with yourselves. I feel like we all need a lot of reminders going back into
normalcy.
The fuck is that word? So stupid. That it's okay to feel crazy, and you're not. It's okay to feel unprepared. It's okay to rest. We don't always have to be bitches to capitalism thinking that rest is unproductive. That's so, so silly. It's okay to stop and say, I am not fucking okay. So I'm only saying that because in my career, my micro, I know I'm only, you're like, you're 7, what do you know? I know enough. I know enough to know that I do not deserve to be put through bullshit more than I need to be.
Woo! Woo!
But I hope you also know the same thing. So this next song I love because Amy reminds me of that in a way. So this is Tears Dry on Their Own.
All I can ever be to you is the darkness that we knew, and this regret I got accustomed to. Once it was so right, when we were at a high, waiting for you in the hotel at night. I knew I had it at my match, but every moment we could snatch. I don't know why I got so attached. It's my responsibility, you don't owe nothing to me, but to walk away I have no capacity. He walks away, the sun goes down, he takes the day, but I'm grown, and in your way, in this blue shade, my tears dry on their own. I don't understand, why do I stress the man, when there's so many bigger things at hand? We could have never had it all, we had to hit a wall, so this is inevitable withdrawal. Even if I stop wanting you, a perspective pushes through. I'll be some next man's other woman soon. I cannot pay myself again, I should just be my own best friend, but I fuck myself in the head with stupid men. He walks away, the sun goes down. And no emotional debts, cause as we kiss goodbye, the sun sets. Oh, so we are history. Your shadow covers me. The sky above us plays only love.
it's so unprofessional to have this iPad, and I hate it too, but I feel so stupid after this past 16 months, y'all. I cannot use my brain. I'll go, oh, it's Monday. And then someone will ask me, what day is it? It's Thursday. What? It's... And then I just lose everything. I lose control. Time, who would you say? Someone said time is what? Time is but a social construct. Oh my God, I feel like we're over mic night. I'm so excited. The way that you speak is so, there's a lot of power there. Appreciate that very much. This song is all relevant to the set. I just thought it'd be really fun. So, here we go. Strong, and I learned how to get along, and now you're from outer space. I just wanted to find you here with that sad look upon your face. I should have changed that stupid life. I should have been delivered to you. If I'd have known just for a second, you'd be up to bother me. Go on now, go. Hey, you walk out the door. I love New York. It's 2 and 4. Thank you very much. Cause you're not welcome anymore. Weren't you the one who tried to hurt me with goodbye? Did you think I crumbled? Did you think I lay down and die? Oh no, not I. I will survive. Oh, as long as I know how to live, I know I'll stay alive. I've got all my life to live. I've got all my love to give. I will survive. I'll survive. Hey, hey. Why am I in a posse? At the end of the show, oppa! So after Kim Dies, we had another great show. The audience was really in it, crying. I'm in Chris's arms, lifeless, and the lights go out to cue the cast to leave the stage so we can get ready for the bows. That evening, somebody was feeling cheeky, or just something happened, and I stood up after my death, talking to Alistair, we're going on stage, and the lights come back up. And now, if you've ever heard the sound of 1900 gasps, you would shit your pants. It was like that. Everyone was like, oh my god, she's alive! Oh my god! And so me, being the professional, very mature actor that I am, Alistair's here. I died again! And then the lights went out, and then everyone applauded again. So, and I was so mad, I was like, what the fuck? I was like, I never liked that at all, but I was so angry. I was like, that was so embarrassing. Who is responsible? I'm so mad. But what I really want to know is who had, I want to pick somebody in that exact audience who had never seen the show, didn't know what it was supposed to be like, and then have them in a room with somebody who knows the show very well. And them go, oh my god, did you see Miss Saigon? Yeah, it's you know, a problematic show. But it was pretty good. The girl was amazing. It's so sad, like, after all that she went through, like, she dies, and she dies again. Bitch, what? Yeah. Do you remember at the end, she dies, and he's like, my god, and then you think it's gonna be happy because she tries to get up again, and then I guess that's when she, like, everything gave out. But that was one of the worst days. It was horrible. 1900 gasps, but also I'm questioning their intelligence as well. To go, do you really think that's in the staging? Yeah, so anyway, when we had that sandwich today, that's what it was like. Who cares? Let's just go into the next one because this is what happens. I think I wrote a good show, and then I just talk in tangents, and then it's like putting a puzzle together with a million random pieces. Who cares? I'm kidding, I do care. You will all know this song. Actually, feel free to sing along, that would be really funny. Yeah! I knew it, I was like, they're gonna lose their shit. I'm gonna have to just keep going.
Sometimes it hurts and stays.
surprise of our glory days. Now I hate to turn up out of the blue uninvited, but I couldn't stay away, I couldn't fight it. I hoped you'd see my face and that you'd be reminded that for me it isn't over. No, no.
Yourself, I will see ID. Again, you have great skin on you. Or I'll fuck with you a little bit, because here's the thing. I want to have to do these three shots. I'm not crazy. I got work tomorrow. Anyway, any volunteers? Yeah, I was going to go to you first. Yeah, West Side.
Let's go.
Always so hype. What's your name, sir? Chris. I mean, he was dead. So, are you a theater person, Chris? Well, either. Your answer was 10 times more complicated than the question. Because, no, you're good, you're good. It just made me laugh. So, good, I can really fuck with you. Okay, so here's what I'll do. Just because I can tell you having a good night, you got the key. Is that the quinoa? What is that? Pharaoh? Good for you. He got a steak. So he's feeling really, really rushed up and hyped from that animal blood. I'm going to, actually, instead of giving you a statement, I'm going to give you a line from a very famous musical. Yeah. And if you don't finish it, calling you home. And here's, please don't be pick me. I know you will probably know the answer. Because I'm in New York City right now, you will look at me, but don't be like, oh, it's, shut up. Please. Okay, so I'm gonna sing the line. Because it's fun this way. This is why audience participation. So, and I like seeing people's faces. I'm like, oh, I know. Okay, so here's the line. You have to finish it. You can't. don't you fret, Monsieur Marius, I don't.
You hear somebody else. Oh!
Monsieur Chris, you got it wrong, Chris. That means you get to drink. He was excited. See, I knew he wanted the shot. See? Salud, salud. Cheers, Chris. A lot of respect if you know it. But my cousin, what are his two names? This is a hard one. Does it end with U and G? Word in the gala, you go anga anga. It's like cuddling. She was like, I'm gonna go with the huh? I am, yeah. All right, Pinoy. That's why. See, that's, any other Filipinos in here? Oh my god, see? Who's mom or tita here? Anyone's mom or tita here? Who's Filipino? You got any Skyplex? You don't get that. See, this is what it means to like not be an inside joke. It really sucks. Sorry. So, you don't know? Okay, does anyone else know? Woo! You can yell it.
Ben and Jerry's.
Ben and Jerry's? Very good guess. Very good guess. Except there's only one?
Tui!
Tui! Who said Tui? Woo! That's what's up. Ow! That's what's up. So, sorry, Andy. I appreciate you. Happy shot. Salud. Salud. Thank you, Andy. Woo! Uber coming. We'll pick you up. We got one more. Yeah! I'm gonna go to the back, but I'm checking with my ID, because you were 5 years old. Going to the back. Oh my god, there's so many people. It's so awesome. Oh my god.
Hi.
Oh, you. The passport.
Yeah, I turned 21 during the
pandemic. Oh my god.
Adrian.
And you're a theater person?
I am the world's biggest theater person, so if you ask me a question and I get it wrong, it will be incredibly
embarrassing.
Oh, shit. It's a drama. If I get it wrong, I go to Carnegie Mellon drama. If I get it wrong, I go to
Oh, shit. I don't understand this reaction.
feel like it's gotta be a trick question where one of them would be like, oh, at high school production or something like that. No? Okay. I'll say true. I'm not sure, but perhaps.
I have been in the London Revival
and the Broadway Revival.
Okay.
Yeah, I would never trick you. How you but you know what got me shocked?
Yes.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Oh my god, it's so amazing here. Oh my god, this is amazing. Thank you, welcome. You're welcome for the shots. Shots are, I personally fucking hate shots, but it's a good way to scare the crowd and also involve them heavily. But on the topic of Miss Saigon, the reason why I was able to be introduced to the next musical that I'm singing from is because of the career-ish that I had. And without the career-ish that I had, I wouldn't have been introduced to the beautiful musical majesty of Hadestown. The best. You coming back? You coming back? Sorry, who's it? I don't know. You'll have to find what? ¿Por qué? I'm not gonna, I'll have your phones off. I'm not gonna give away something. I'm not gonna give away anything.
Come on!
Who?
Reeve?
Reeve? You're asking me, he's right there.
Yeah!
In fact, are you gonna go to the bathroom? Yeah. I was gonna ask if you wanted to sing All I've Ever Known with me.
Yeah! Yeah! Come on.
Reeve, come back.
I promise you're almost done. This is chaos. Right, so let's just get into it, I guess.
I've lost track of where we are.
Oh my gosh.
Sorry about that, everyone.
We forgive you because the accent's really cool.
Love you very much. Only fools rush in, but I can't help falling in. Thank you.
Everyone knows it's all I've ever known is how to hold my own, not hold. it just makes me giggle. It's fine. I just, it is a little appropriate when you switch just that one letter. So here goes nothing.
Close.
Beautiful faces celebrating music again. It's awesome. So yeah, this song has nothing to do with what I just said, but we're gonna sing it. We're gonna sing it again. If there's a prize for my children, oh good, I guess I've already won that. And the man is worth the aggravation. That's ancient history been there.
man that won you has run off and undone you. That great beginning has seen a final end. Don't know what happened, it's all a crazy game. Goodbye, every trick of his.